You drive too fast.
Matt, I was going to speed limit.
You drive my limit.
Just relax, huh?
Relax. Look at your life.
What? What? For Christ's sakes. How's Pa?
Nice of you to ask.
I don't want to get into a big discussion. Is he feeling all right?
You think he likes that you kill people?
Ma, I don't kill people.
You kill people.
What, are you fucking kidding me?
I should cut your tongue out. You think you're with the bums you hang out with.
You're telling me I kill people. Who is nuts in this car?
You work for your Uncle Sam. You don't think I know what he does? He's a killer. You work for him, you're a killer.
Ma, the guy is a fucking jeweler. He ain't no killer. Sometimes he may move a good piece. What's wrong with that? He's a fence, not a killer.
So, you're a fence? Madonna mia, you should never have got mixed up with your uncle.
Ma, do I have to go through this fucking bullshit every time I see you? At least Uncle Sammy isn't a bum like Pa. The man has class. He gets respect.
Your father's an honest man.
Being honest is not how you make it. How hard did he work? Where did it get him? Fuck that, Ma. Fuck that.
Your mouth. Your fucking mouth. Who taught you to talk like this? Sam is my brother. You only see him now. He has led a ruthless, terrible life.
So what?
He's using you, Nick. You're his last hope at loyalty. In a crunch, he's alone. Next time you come, pick me up sausages, the kind with the fennel.
You got it. See you later.
Of Italian sausage.
How exciting. I just lost my appetite.
You? They should declare a national fucking holiday.
That must be a difficult thing, being half Italian, half Jew. Knishes, matzo balls, that fish shit in a jar. No wonder you look like you do.
Joe, you think I want to look like you? Huh? When's the last time you saw your dick?
Hey. As long as the broad who's sucking on it can see it, that's all that matters.
Where's Nicky?
He's with his mother.
When he gets here, send him back to me.
Sure.
You want me to go down to Sparrows?
No.
Who's going?
I'm sending Nicky.
You think that's a good idea? That's not right, Frankie. That's my run. Nicky's never done nothing. He's just a kid.
You're out of line, Joe.
I didn't agree with you.
What's right is right.
Hello? way down the fucking stairs to tell me this? What else is new?
You know, you're one real happy bitch.
Bitch, yes. Happy, no.
Another one. I'll leave one mental case to go to another. I gotta be out of my mind.
No wonder there's so many fucking queens walking around.
Is that why you won't be home tonight?
I don't have time for this.
Where are you rushing to?
Going down to see Sam, then I'm going with Sally Boys.
You have time for a quick one?
What's the matter? No one coming here today to fix something?
You're not gonna believe who did stop by this morning.
Okay.
Julie.
Julie who?
Frankie's wife.
What that yet don't want?
She asked me to sign a piece of paper.
What was on it?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
It was blank.
Blank? What, you think you're stupid?
I signed it.
What? What the fuck did you just say? What did I just hear? What did I just fucking hear?
Stop fucking shouting!
Didn't you ask what it was for? Weren't you even curious?
I wasn't thinking, all right? It's for some court crap. That guy she was working for that she robbed blind. You remember? It was something for that.
What's the sense?
You know, I don't need this fucking shit! Fuck you, fucking hotshot! You always do everything right, asshole! I'm going to my mother's! Kiss my ass, Nicky! Kiss my ass!
You're taking me wrong, Donna! I don't want you in any trouble, you know how these people are!
You seem to like being around them, Nick.
I'll call you later. We'll go out to dinner.
Hey, Nicky. Where the fuck were you all day?
Jerk it off, Frankie.
Yeah, well, go see your uncle. He's been looking for you.
Please. What's the shit? What brings you down here?
Just doing some business with your uncle.
What's wrong, huh?
Can't be too careful around you boys.
Speaking of boys, who's the kid?
This is my little brother. Tough kid.
Breaking
him
in young.
Yeah.
Came along to see some Italian pussy. You are young. If you see me, let me know so I can run the other way. Watch you all around this way, huh?
It's been a pleasure.
Hey, Tommy.
Hey, Kevin.
How are you, man?
Same old.
Yeah? Looking well?
Thanks.
Hey, softball this year, this spring?
Great time this year.
We'll get a team going? Third baseman.
Oh, don't worry. I have a great one this year.
I'm looking forward to it.
Definitely.
Good deal. What's up?
How's the dream card going for the girl?
Don't worry about it, everything's okay. Give us about a month or so, right? No problem. How about a shot of McCallum's? Appreciate it.
Hey, Nick.
Yeah?
Your dad used to say, be careful where you're going. And you don't know where you've been.
I appreciate that, Tom.
I've been hanging around the mix too long.
You're going on a job today. Don't get loaded up.
Yeah, after this fucking day, I can use the whole bottle. 3 fucking hours to get here. 3 fucking hours. The tunnel is fucking backed up. These toe clippers are slow as shit. Good thing I wasn't having a heart attack. I'd be fucking doomed.
Settle down. You're here now.
And Frankie, what is this shit? Your wife is asking my dad to sign blank paper. What the fuck is that? What job?
Talk to your uncle, huh?
Deserved it. She's sleeping all over the fucking place. She deserved to get her throat cut.
That's nice of her, Sammy.
I mean, you don't agree? What would you do if your wife was laying everything in sight? She deserved it.
She might be.
What are you talking?
Nothing. What's this I hear about a job?
I want you to make the run down Sparrows.
That's Fat Joe's job.
I know. I want you to start going out a little more. Making the rounds. Use your own crew.
Sparrow's a sick fuck. I know he's gonna give me a hard time.
He's 2 months late in his payments. Fat Joe's a hothead. I don't want no trouble. I haven't closed my eyes to Sparrow's habits. I'm sure you're aware of them. It's not good for business.
What a sick fuck. I don't know why it's telling me. The guy hasn't done a job in 20 years.
Just get the money. Keep it clean. Too many people are making money out of that place. Close a den like that down, like shutting the stock exchange down. The fuck runs a good den?
What did Fat Joe have to say about it?
I make the decisions.
All right. I'll take Sally if I want to.
Just keep him under control. If he's anything like his Uncle Marty.
No, it'll be all right. That's my boy.
We used to be like that a long time ago. Listen, I need to discuss some things with you. It'll wait till I come back.
Where you going?
I have to go out of town on business. I'm flying to Zurich tomorrow. Action's been a little slow lately. I'll mail you some checks. Look for them. We'll talk in a few days.
Let me do all the talking, all right, Sally boy?
Okay, sure, boss.
Fuck is this homo? Shut up.
Joe Sparrow. Sparrow. Cool it, man. I hear something in the back.
Next. Who are you talking to? Hey, wrong person. I'm sorry.
Fuck.
What do you two punks want?
It's Nicky Giante, Sammy's nephew.
Where's Fat Joe?
They sent me today.
Who's that with you?
It's Salvatore Malone, he's a friend of mine.
What is this bullshit, 1,000 fucking questions?
You're Malone's kid.
His nephew.
Here you go, Nick.
Thank you, Sparrow.
Marty Malone used to be a good customer. Fucking drunk made everyone money.
What the fuck?
I used to enjoy throwing the fucking bum out. Then you mix can't help that.
Let's just go, Sparrow.
You hear this, cocksucker? What are you, fucking nuts?
Forget it. Let's just go.
I don't understand why Sam sends a schoolboy and his Mick friend. What's this shit all about?
Hey, Joe, I think you said enough.
Yo, you're real tough. I just fucked two punks tougher than you. One sucked my balls. Maybe you'd like to do the same, huh?
Faggot! That's me! Don't you ever fuck the Malone!
What don't you know?
I'm sorry, Nick. I'm fucking sorry. He had it coming. Just tell Sam what happened. He would have done the same thing. Just tell him what happened.
Yeah. Sam would have just walked out, not said two words. Nothing.
Bullshit!
A couple of days, maybe a month, maybe a year, Sparrow would have gotten his. Uncle Sam told me, never make an emotional decision. Never!
What's gonna happen now?
I don't know. If he's still alive, probably you sit down. You know, the same old bullshit.
But if he's dead?
Well, that may be the best thing. He wasn't a very liked person.
He fucked teenage boys. What is that? And why the fuck they let him stay in business?
I don't know. He pulled a couple of key buttons a long time ago. Let me call the bar.
Congratulations. Our friend Sparrow just found out things only dead men know.
What?
You just completed your first unauthorized button of a made man.
Cool. What do we do now?
Tell you the truth. Fucking horny. You say we get laid.
Let's go.
Call up Rose and her friend. Go back to the condo, huh?
Where's Donna?
She's at her mother's house. Hey, maybe you wouldn't mind killing her too?
I'm gonna give you candy. Come on to my house. I'm gonna give you an apple and a plum and an apricot or two. Hey, come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, come on. I'm gonna give you figs and dates and the grapes and the cakes. Hey, come on to my house, come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you candy. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you everything.
Nothing, Nicky.
Nothing? You're not your usual self.
You say you love me, right? But I only see you when you need to get laid. And yet, you still live with Donna, who you say you hate.
Sex once in a while. No problems. You never told me you wanted anything more.
Bullshit. What? Fuck me? Then drive me back to the slums? Meanwhile, that spoiled bitch is living on the beach? No more.
You liked it. You liked it. Oh, that's the girl. That's the
girl. Oh, fuck, it's big.
Oh, Marie. You want to marry me? Oh, yeah. Come on, Rose. You know how I feel about you. Don't ruin a good thing.
Good for who?
I can't just get rid of Donna. You mean a lot to me, but you know who her father is.
I don't care.
I promise. As soon as I straighten a couple of things out, you and me are gonna be together. I promise. Shit. Good. Fuck you. You can walk back to Linden Boulevard. You belong there.
Marie, let's go.
1 minute.
No, now.
All right. You called me, Sally boy.
What was that all about?
Who knows?
You sure got away with broads. Man, that Marie was some piece. Man, can she work? She gotta be a virgin.
What do you say that?
She kept telling me how big it was.
Yeah, I guess she hasn't seen too many.
I could marry a girl like that.
Sparrow's dead. Nicky and Sally boy killed him. tells me they went there to collect the money, and Sparrow starts putting down Marty Malone, saying shit to him, calling him a bum and a drunk. And Sparrow starts with Nicky. Sally Boy went for him. Nicky joined him.
They shoot him?
No, just threw him a good beating. Me and Fat Joe took care of the body.
Who knows?
As far as I can tell from what I picked up in the street, no one. There's rumors around that some hustler kids did it, then robbed him. You know what he was into. Sounds logical to me.
Thank you, Frank. You handled things real well. Thank Fat Joe for me also.
Fat Joe's been running the place since. We're asking around for someone who's looking for some fixed income.
Get Nicky and her long kid in here right away.
This.
Sammy.
Sammy who?
How many Sammys do you know? Sammy Giante.
Sammy, for Christ's sake. You guinea bastard. How are you?
Tips and all, making a living. How you feeling, Marty?
Holding up, Sammy. Can't be climbing any fire escapes, Sammy.
We haven't done that in a long time. Good days. Good days.
You know it. Damn it. All the swag in New York coming through our fingers. The biggest and best heist in the world we go to.
Marty. Sally Boy and Nicky.
Isn't that something? Those two kids together, just like we were. That's something. Remember those three sisters? The singing ones.
The McGuire sisters.
Yeah, that's it. Sammy, the McGuire sisters. We had a set.
We had men in every hotel.
What was that fellow's name we used to put up in the rooms?
Joe Snaps. He was the best. He could take a diamond out of a setting and replace it faster than anyone.
We were greedy on that one. We should have just switched some of the stuff. Kids. Just kids. Smart. Kids. Poor Harry.
He didn't even know what happened. Took the rap for that one.
About you? You in a deal?
A few things here and there. I have the old timers still come around to move some things. I don't like dealing with the younger bunch. Can't trust them.
Sammy, it's nice to talk to you. I'm feeling a little tired. Was there something you wanted to tell me?
No. No, Marty. I just wanted to see how you're doing.
That's nice, Sammy. Come around sometime.
So long, Marty.
Thank you. blame Nicky.
Well, hey, what's going on?
Frankie sent me out to find him. I think Sam wants to speak with him.
Now, Frankie's a lazy fuck. He should have told him to go do it himself. It ain't like you got nothing to do.
It's no trouble at all.
Well, look up the block. I'll see you later. Duty calls.
Thanks, Phil.
This freaking nut job who feeds the pigeons all the time.
He's
up on the roof.
He's always on the fucking roof.
He's on the roof.
He's
always on the roof.
He's always on the roof.
He's
always
on the
roof. I jerk off up there sometimes.
Hey, Tommy, what's going on, man?
Hey, Sally.
The lumberjack's here.
Tommy, what's going on? Honey. How you doing?
Frankie sent me for you.
Why didn't he come himself?
Anything wrong? Come on, take a walk.
Yo, guys, you got
it wrong.
You
got
it
already?
Yeah, man.
Stay the fuck out of trouble.
There's no trees.
Yeah, right. Okay. Sparrow? I think so, from what I heard. Sam and Frank were talking in the background.
What did they say?
Come on, Tommy, you can tell us. I think Frank explained everything.
Sam sound mad?
I didn't hear no one yelling. But then again, I never heard Sam yell.
Did you hear anything about the body?
Fat Joe and Frank took care of it. You know Fat Joe. He takes his job very seriously. As I heard it, cut out his lungs. He dumped the body in the Creighton Reservoir.
Why'd he bother to cut his lungs out?
So he wouldn't float to the top.
Makes sense.
Tommy, thank you. I know what you want.
I'll make sure that car comes a lot faster.
Thanks, Nick.
Yeah, thanks, Tommy.
Hey, you a good man,
right? Anytime I can help out. Better pick some things up for the bar, all right? See you soon, and good luck.
Boys, you guys hungry?
No.
Sit down.
Hi, Uncle Sam.
Hello, Sam. I spoke to your uncle today, Salvatore. He isn't feeling too well, is he? He's all right. Can't walk or nothing, but he's okay. Did you mention anything to him? You mean, did I tell him you fucked up big time? Did I tell him you killed a made man without anyone's permission? Did I tell him you came this close to never being seen again? No, I didn't, you stupid fuck. Think I wanted to give him a heart attack?
The guy went off.
Shut your mouth, Nicky. Shut your mouth. What the hell were you two thinking? Two fucking thinking, no little pea heads of yours. What do you think, you're tough guys now? I don't know if I can ever trust you again, Nicky.
Sam, go easy.
Go easy? The three of you, get out of here now. Now! Get back. Nicky, Sally boy, this is my mistake. And the only reason I'm gonna forgive you guys, this, I didn't like that fuck. You boys got off easy.
Uncle Sam, thank you.
Thank you, Sam. Get Fat Joe in here.
Joey! Hey, Sam.
Sit down. job for us boys. Do you remember the La Villa Rouge heist?
Yeah, that was, 20 years ago.
Yeah, the fellas who pulled it off came to me with the goods. It was a big score, over 100 different items.
That's the heist that brought in the colored scum, the one I was treated.
The one the GIA said was real.
What's the GIA?
That's the Gemological Institute of America.
That's good, Nicky. That's right, Frank. They said it was real. You sent it to Zurich to test it. They have a place there where they can bring it down to a certain temperature. And by that, study the molecular structure.
I don't understand why you go through so much trouble for one stone.
It was an aqua diamond, green diamond. Very rare.
It was so rare. How come nobody picked up on it or recorded it stolen?
As any good fence does when it comes across a good piece. He grinds it down just a little to change the weight of the stone. This way, they don't have the same stone.
We can bring the stone down from 2.6 carats to 2.5 carats. New stone.
That's simple.
The director of the Zurich Institute sent us back the stone and a certificate stating it was real. But color treated, rendering it a phony.
These guys are pushing a phony stone?
Mind you, it was being sold by one of the most prestigious houses in New York.
But didn't you get something like $400,000 for it?
Yes. The GIA gave me a certificate of authenticity. I never said anything about the Zurich study.
It's incredible how you knew the value of the piece.
Being a good fence that people will come to move their goods requires a bit of knowledge about jewelry, antiques, things like that.
Who bought it from you?
I put it up for auction at Sotheby's.
In fucking credible!
I would have done the same thing.
So what does this have to do with us?
Well, it was another stone. Another piece. Shaped like a heart. Couldn't get rid of this fucking thing for years. My friends didn't want it. My customers didn't want it. I was only asking $500 for it. I just wanted to get rid of it.
Well, why didn't you bring that up to Sotheby's?
Couldn't be altered. I had to wait for the statute of limitations to run out.
So what happened with it?
An old art dealer finally took it off my hands. Guy I'd done business with before was always trying to chisel me. Not this time. As soon as I showed it to him, he grabbed it.
How much?
$3,000. It's a good small score, and I finally got rid of it.
I still don't get it.
I want it back.
So tell him you want to buy it back.
It's not that simple. Turns out that this heart is part of a Fabergé collection.
You mean like the eggs from Russia?
Worth two, maybe $3 million.
I want to get the house painted.
That's a good idea. How about we paint it pink, stand out from the crowd?
I'm serious.
The house matches everyone else's. You just can't paint it any color.
Did you hear anything about Sparrow? Lisa, who serves coffee over there at night, said it was some of those kids that hang out there during the day. What puzzles me is if these kids did it, how did they get rid of the body without no one seeing it? It doesn't make sense.
Why are you so concerned? The fucking guy's gone. Forget it.
Where are you going?
How do you know I'm going somewhere?
Because you have your tools and your clothes stuffed in a bag in the garage. You're going on a job.
Are you sure you're not a cop?
My father doesn't breed cops.
Yeah, that's true.
Is it a big one?
Well, put it this way. If all goes well, I'll finally be able to quit this lousy business.
We'll be set up for a long time.
How long this time?
But you're around. At least a couple of weeks.
You know, we haven't talked about marriage in a long time. Kids, a family.
Donna, we've been through this before. I'm not ready yet. I might get something fixed, permanent, you know.
You gotta start somewhere. Why not here?
Shut up, the light and come here. Let's see what happens in the next couple of weeks.
Say hello to your father. He wants to see you.
I can't. I gotta go. I gotta run.
You can't avoid him forever. He's your father. You can't agree with him on everything, but he's your father. Please, come in. Say hello for me.
For you, huh? You're playing hardball. Listen, in a couple of weeks maybe. I love you, but I gotta go. I'll talk to you, okay?
It's lonely, you know?
You all go through these things. She'll be all right. I'll send Beach or something to keep her company.
That's good, Joe.
How do you feel about doing a job with Sally Boy and Nicky?
Well, you gotta admit, the kid Sally Boy's got balls. Nicky's soft. I can sense it. He don't like to work. He just likes the rewards.
Yeah, they're both too young. I agree. I think Sam is pushing Nick. He's not cut out for this dirty work.
I guarantee if anything comes from this job, Nicky's taking the high road to China.
We'll see.
Sally Boy, on the other hand, likes it too much. Reminds me of Marty.
Marty Malone.
Mm-hmm.
He was a good man. I don't see the comparison. Should have got my nails done. Look at this.
I went yesterday.
Thanks a lot. I would have went with you. Have a coffee, slugger. I'll put some whiskey in it for you.
How about a little Zambuca?
And some bagels in the bag.
Where is everyone?
The fuck do I look like?
Oh, don't answer that, Sally boy.
How long you think this is gonna take?
It depends on what Sam has decided. It should be a quick job.
Keep your mouth shut and everything will be nice.
Sam's looking for Nicky.
Tell him we're waiting on him.
He's lit again.
Old news, huh?
I got the most incredible blowjob the other day.
Hanging around the village again, huh?
This girl Nikki's seen, her friend. Real hot Spanish broad. Mm. I could be in love.
Oh.
Love is a relative thing. In that moment, you love the fact you were getting a great blowjob. It may linger for a couple of days, but it does not constitute love in any real sense. Will you still be in love when the blowjobs ain't coming so often? That's what you gotta ask yourself.
Fucking Play-Doh.
Nicky's still hanging around with this Spanish girl?
Yeah, once in a while.
It's gonna get him in trouble. Sam don't even like it.
Sounds like a lot of old world bullshit. She's a nice girl.
What about Donna?
She can be a real pain in the ass. Anyhow, I don't see it as your business.
Anything that affects business is our business.
You should be talking to Nick, then.
Relax, eat something.
Hey, fellas.
Hey, we're waiting on you.
Hey, I had to stop at my mom's.
Joey.
For you.
You stopped at Maria's Bakery? Fresh semolina. Come here, give me a kiss.
Get out of here. What's up, Sally boy?
You got Rose's number?
Yeah, what do you want it for?
I want to call Marie.
I don't think it's a good idea yet. They're trying to call Rose a week every time of my calls.
Come on. Sam wants to talk to us, then we gotta go, huh?
You looking good, Nick.
Yeah, you look so bad yourself. You're starting to look like a rich man.
You think?
I think. What the fuck was that all about anyway, you? This fucking guy.
You all know your jobs. This could set us all up for a long time. Make him an offer of his money back. If he doesn't want the deal, give him some incentive. Everything goes right, by next month we'll be in Bermuda opening up bank accounts.
What if he refuses?
What do you mean, if he doesn't accept that generous offer?
Yes.
Nicky, you'd be surprised how the right kind of persuasion can change somebody's mind.
Nicky, you don't have to go.
Yes, he does.
Why push him? Let him stay.
What kind of shit is this? It's important we put on a good show. Maybe we ought to forget the whole fucking thing.
Sorry, Sam. I figured it's an easy job. Why should all four of us have to go?
Stress one thing to any hothead in this room. No one gets hurt on this job. No one. It's clean, in and out. Understood?
Don't worry, Sam. I'll take care of it. I'll keep him under control.
Who's gonna keep you under control?
South, where the trains run fast, a monkey stuck his finger up a baboon's ass. The baboon said, "Damn your soul, go stick your finger up your own ass."
You fucking sick bastard.
What a Paul.
Come on, please.
She's got to get home already. I promised Julie I would take her out. Why don't we just look for this thing ourselves? What's the sense? It might not be here.
It's easy to ask him.
What are you doing, Sal?
What the fuck? It's ganja, man. Mary Jane, the essence of the earth.
What are you, stupid? I don't want to smell that shit.
So don't breathe.
Come on, Sal. This ain't the right time.
It's Sally Boy, Nick. Sally Boy.
Put the radio on, huh?
What's this guy doing?
I like him. He's that skinny Jew with the bad voice.
I'm glad you like him.
Yeah, right. What the fuck is the name of that song he wrote?
Blowing in the Wind?
No.
Like a Rolling Stone.
No.
Tangled Up in Blue.
He had that many fucking songs?
Anybody want some of this?
No, thanks.
Frank?
That stuff affects your sex drive.
I got it. Something like, hey, you're gonna have to do something, but something like that.
Where the fuck is this guy?
He'll be here. Calm your ass down. Come here. Sit here or watch some TV.
Hey, fuck you. I'm fucking hungry.
Smoke some more of that crap.
99 little sluts in a wall. 99 little sluts.
You
take one down, you smack her around.
98 little sluts on a wall.
98 little sluts on a wall. 98 little sluts.
You find a bed, she gives you a head.
97 little sluts on a wall.
97 little sluts on a wall.
97 little sluts.
Say, Frankie, why don't you sing one?
I ain't singing this nonsense.
Oh, come on, it's the greatest.
I'll let this one pass if she licks my ass.
Oh, 96 little sluts on the wall. 96 little sluts.
You two got problems.
Oh, man.
We used to sing that when we was kids. We had that whole song down.
That was good days.
Yeah. Let's just get this job done.
Keep your eyes open for this guy, huh, Nicky?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm getting a little hungry.
Where is he?
Where's who?
The fucking guy, the fucking dealer. Where is he?
Hey, calm your nerves. This is part of it, Nick. You look the part, now play it.
All right, enough. You know he gets home around this time. Isn't that right, Sal?
That's right.
Great. You've been sticking him out, I didn't know.
It's only for a couple days, Nick.
Yeah. We know. You don't like to wait.
It's no big deal, Nicky. What else don't I know about?
I hear a call.
Shut the TV. Nicky, Sally, we'll go in the other room and wait.
Listen, Frankie, you let him in, I'll greet him.
Okay.
Piece of jewelry you purchased from Sam Giante.
Who are these two?
Oh, I'm Nicky Giante. I'm Sammy's nephew.
Very nice place. You're doing some job.
Salvatore Malone. My friends call me Sally Boy.
Well, now we all know each other. Let's talk about the piece.
Sold it. No, to a man I see sometimes.
Where can we find him?
Well, I don't know. He only comes in two, maybe three times a year.
What's his name?
I don't know. I swear.
Arthur, we can make this simple or hard.
Now, Sam is willing to return you $3,000. Tell me where the stone is.
Tell him, Arthur.
Well, I am telling you. I don't know. I swear.
Well, let me jog your memory.
Wait, maybe he doesn't know.
The fuck knows? Arthur, you got any pasta? Any food?
Yes.
Good. I'm gonna cook us a nice little meal. I think better on a full stomach. When we're through eating, I'm gonna ask you one more time where that piece is. If you don't tell us, Nicky here is gonna start pulling out your teeth. One by one.
Now please, let me just talk to Sam. He'll believe me. Please?
Call Sam.
He told me to kill you as soon as I saw you.
You still want me to call him?
Thank you.
fucking delicious, man. Mm. And you cook.
I gotta admit, that was good.
Thanks, boys.
What are we gonna do with this guy?
Not much of a choice.
Tell him where it is.
Asshole! Don't be a dumb fuck! I haven't killed anyone in a few weeks. I'm itching.
Fellas, I hate to break up this little party, but we're behind schedule. Sam hasn't heard from us, and we gotta do something with this schmuck over here.
It's up to him.
He ain't saying nothing.
Why don't you take the tape off his mouth?
I'm doing it. He ain't gonna talk. Bring him to the bathtub. I'll take care of him.
You have to discuss that in front of him.
It's a privilege to know when and how the occurrence of your death is going to take place. Mm-hmm. I do that out of respect. How many men would like that knowledge?
Hey, take the tape off his mouth, eh? Maybe he's hungry.
Please. Please, I have money. I'll give you money. Don't kill me. Please.
Shut up!
Please!
Oh, big the fuck! I gotta listen to this while I'm digesting?
Just relax.
You wanna eat?
No. I need my medicine. Please, my medicine. Give me my medicine.
What's wrong with you?
It's my stomach. I have an ulcer. I need my Tagamet.
No one uses that shit no more. You must have an old doctor that's prescribed it for you.
Please don't kill me. Don't kill
me! Come
on,
gag him! You can't listen to him beg like that!
No, it is very common.
What?
For doctors to prescribe things that aren't really modern anymore. Like when the salad boy here had that giant wart in the bottom of his foot.
Oh, go tell the whole fucking world!
This doctor over at the Union says to him, he goes, he's got to put a 2-inch needle through the bottom of his foot.
It's my foot. Let me tell the story. This doctor over at the Union tells me I got a wart on the bottom of my foot. I didn't know it was a wart. I thought I had a piece of glass in there. Anyhow, this guy, Dr. Tushy, told me something like that. Tells me the only way to get the wart out of my foot is to cut it out.
You should have seen this guy with his legs up in the air in his fucking chair. He looked like he was giving birth.
I says to the guy, what are you talking about? There's gotta be another way. He tells me they make a cut on both sides of the wart, like a football, and that this is very painful. And if it does not heal right, I will have a scar. And every time I will walk, I would feel pain. Would you believe this? Every time I walk, I would feel pain.
Hey, you know how it feels. Every time I look at you, I feel pain.
What's the point of this?
Well, let me finish the story. Nicky tells me this broad, who's a foot doctor, she does this procedure where she takes a needle, she puts it in the top of your foot instead of the bottom, which is much less painful. And after it numbs, she uses a laser to burn it out and heal it up at the same time.
What's the fucking point?
Just be careful who you go to. Get a second opinion. These doctors get lazy.
He's right. Not too many doctors prescribe Tagamet for ulcers.
Enough bullshit. He's gonna need a dentist. Hmm. Nicky, take care of him.
Frankie, give him time to find the guy.
Joe, go ahead.
I will do it. Enough said.
All right. All right. I have it. I'll give it to you.
You make us wait around this long. And now you tell me you have it. Now what am I gonna do with you?
I wasn't thinking. You can keep the money.
Pull out a tooth.
What?
Pull his fucking tooth out!
Leave him alone!
You can't just let him walk!
Oh, let the guy be! He said he has it! What the fuck?
No! Please! Out for this type of work.
It wasn't very nice of you.
What? At that guy office?
Yes, that guy Arthur's. You should have stood with me.
You're wrong, Nicky. We gotta let people know not to fuck with us.
The guy was scared shit. We got what we wanted. Wasn't that enough?
True. But now he's scared shit and Cooper's.
You're too fucking funny. I saw those two kids the other day.
Oh.
Kids were sparrows.
So what? They're punks. Would you relax, man? You're starting to snap on me.
I gotta get out of the city. What if all this bullshit plays on you, you know? So fucking constant, never stops. Get to this job, I think I'm gonna pack it in. The sparrow thing is bothering me.
You're thinking too much, man.
No way to be in this business without getting your hands dirty. Every once in a while, there's gonna be somebody in the way. Someone needs to be taken out. And it's only a matter of time before you or I are the ones that are in the way.
I don't know. I like it. Better than walking a beat like my father. A cop for 20 years. Guy got nothing but cirrhosis of the liver. No thanks. 20 years in a pension? That ain't for me.
Look at Sam and Uncle Marty. 30 years goes by, where'd it get them? Sam's still looking for the big score. Marty's burned out.
Sam is fucking loaded.
What good is it? He can't go and spend it. Every time he needs 20 grand, he has to fly to Zurich. No big house. Just a new Lincoln every year and some custom-made shirts. If you look at him, you'd think he was a pauper.
Money is money. Besides, it's the game. The excitement of it. Knowing you're getting over on these pricks who run things. That's what it's all about. Once it's in your blood, it's there for good. You think you'd ever be able to hold down a legitimate job? Never, man. Never.
The Shylocks, the loan sharks, the bookies, all the riffraff. I don't care if I ever meet one again.
Nick, you have a craft. Sam taught you all about stones and gems. Just be a fence. What's the difference? Let the other people do the dirty work.
The fence needs them to stay in business. You got a guy. He's a player, a gambler, right? This guy loses and he loses. He goes to a loan shark, he borrows money. He keeps on gambling, loses more money. He goes out and steals. Takes what he's got to a guy like Sam, the fence. Sam in turns, buys what he needs, then tells the shark what he gave this guy for the goods. Loan shark gets paid, then tells the fellow who's running the poker den that the guy has money. As soon as he walks through the door, he's mocked. It starts all over again. Everybody's sucking off of each other. It's one big happy family.
Well, it's the only family I got.
Hey,
chopped his balls off. You did good, Sally boy.
Thanks, Sam.
What happens now?
The hut's a certified Fabergé. I asked you guys to wait a few weeks for things cool down. It seems like nobody's missing it. So it's on the block.
Where do you want to get for it?
Well, here's the good news. The base's starting price was set at... Are you ready, Frankie? $500,000 before bidding.
Holy Christ, we hit pay dirt.
How high do you suppose the bidding could go?
Yeah, how high?
Something in the ballpark of...
Come on, Sam, come on.
Three or four beans.
Beans?
What kind of beans?
Kind of beans with six zeros attached to them.
Whoa, 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 excuse me if I'm wrong.
You do mean 3 or 4 million?
That is correct.
Oh, West Broadway, here I come.
Sam, is that really a feasible number? I mean, this bozo had this fucking piece on his windowsill, for Christ's sakes.
You're probably lucky. He didn't know the true value of it.
This is a good score, I must say.
It's not over until we have that money on our hands. Anything can go wrong.
What do you mean?
Let's not forget who it was originally stolen from. La Villa Rouge does a lot of swapping around the auction houses. It's unlikely that after all these years, the same guy is still there. But who knows? If I feel it's hot, we'll pull it out and try it at the Park Monet Gallery.
What would happen if La Villa whatever did take notice to it?
They'd probably claim ownership and stop the bidding.
I mean, wouldn't you get in trouble? Couldn't they question you?
Probably not. There must have been hefty insurance on that piece, and the rightful owner probably collected. So even if he did stop the bid in, I'm sure he'd take it back, no questions asked. And both of us would bow out gracefully.
Now that would be a nice score for him.
Let's hope not. We'll know tomorrow. Go home. Be at 3 p.m.
I ain't sleeping tonight.
Nicky, stay here. I want to have a word with you.
No, Frank. You going over to Williamsburg?
Yeah. Come on, Sally boy. We'll drop you off.
Cool.
Yo, Nicky.
I'm gonna... Take care, Joe. Oh, bye-bye, Sally boy. Frankie.
Hey, Nicky.
See you there, baby.
Ciao.
Take care. So long, fellas. So, looks like we pulled it off.
That's what it looks like.
It's any mind, Unc. Something's bothering you.
Nicky. I feel I failed you. Brought you into a terrible world.
What is that nonsense? I wouldn't be anywhere without you.
No. I had the resources to help you in a lot of ways. Could have paid for any college. You're too smart. You don't need this.
Uncle Sam, tomorrow I expect to collect more money than most people could think about making in a lifetime. You made that possible. It was school. That was my choice, nobody else's.
You're like my son. I taught you what I know. Now I say this to you. After this is over, I want you out of this business. There is no such thing as respect with these people. No one respects each other. It all has to do with fear. Without fear, you have nothing.
I'm aware of that. More than ever.
Nicky, you're not a killer. And to protect what's yours from these vultures, you have to kill. From time to time, it happens.
Have you?
I've been down here in the Bowery my whole life. I fought in World War II. People have died in their war, and people have died in mine.
The fellas think I'm weak. Wouldn't pull that guy's teeth out. Do you?
No. Guys like Frankie, Fat Joe, they're like puppy dogs. They lick your fingers, hands, then your feet. Soon they want to be like you. They look to get rid of you.
Well, I was looking to get out, but after the score,
once in a lifetime. Maybe twice if you're lucky. Take the money and run. Listen to me. I can only tell you what I know.
Through the eyes of a fence.
The best around.
Thank you.
I was speaking to your mother. Make peace with your father, Nick. He's a good man.
Answer the fucking phone.
Yeah, hello. Yeah. Your friend. What's wrong?
What are you talking about?
He said goodbye to me tonight. In his own way, he said goodbye.
What about the money? What are we gonna do about tomorrow?
You're a real fucking winner. That is the last thing on my mind.
Don't get all nuts on me. There's a lot of money at stake here. A lot of fucking money.
That mouth of yours, you're a slob, Donna. Is that all you can think about? My life is as good as over. If Sam dies, I'm dead. They're gonna kill me.
Bullshit, I'll tell my father.
Even your father can't help me on this one. Go back home and stay there.
Nicky, come back here! Nicky!
Job here.
What would the place be without you?
It's gonna be quiet without Sam. He was a good man.
If I can do anything for you, please let me know.
Thank you.
It's not right.
What's that?
I mean, he was supposed to enjoy the money. It belonged to him.
He took joy in the fact that we pulled it off. It was a good job.
Oh.
A good job.
He never got to find out how much we got for it.
I don't think he thought we ever would have gotten that much.
I think he knew.
You're right, you know.
Sam Shea's gonna split up four ways. That's what he wanted.
You don't have to do that, Nicky.
Yeah, Nick, you're gonna need it.
Man, I can't spend what I got now. Now you guys deserve it.
Most appreciated.
Gonna miss you, Nick.
I ain't going nowhere.
I thought you said you was going away for a while.
Yeah, right. I'm gonna go and teach ethical business practices at Harvard University.
Okay. Oh, don't laugh. Those kids would make a lot of cash taking that course.
Those fucking punks. They couldn't do nothing except steal pens and pencils.
See, I think I'll be around for a while.
You need time off. Take it. And we'll watch the shop.
I'll keep all your accounts open. Don't you worry about a thing.
I ain't worried. As long as no one calls you a drunken Mick, we'll be okay.
Come on, we were thinking about using him as a bar back.
Oh, good idea. I thought he was our new coffee boy. Hey, boy, go get me some coffee.
Oh, sure. What do you want? Piss, crap, what?
Ooh,
surprise you, right?
You got some mouth on you.
God, you think about the people you're hanging around
with. You shouldn't complain. The mix went out.
Didn't we find him on the front step with a note stapled to his forehead?
Right?
To whom it may concern.
Please, take this one beginning from us.
Listen, you half-jewel. In a minute, I'm gonna fuck you in the ass. I wonder about this kid always hanging around in the village.
Anyway, listen, guys. I'm gonna call it a night. I'll step back here in the morning. I'll tie up some loose ends, all right?
Go ahead. We'll clean up. Tomorrow, you and I will talk.
Have a good one.
Now walk into your car.
No. Stay here. Good night, guys. Good. Fat Joe. Take care of yourself.
Take care.
All right, boy.
I'll see you more.
What a fucking day, huh?
I'm gonna miss that old bastard. He would walk in the room. It was like General Patton was there. I don't know anyone who could command respect like that. Mm-hmm. And it was respect.
Mm-hmm.
The things this man did and got away with boggles my mind.
He was a tough bastard. I mean, He just had a look at you.
That's it. He knew where you stood. He was a good man.
Listen, Frankie, I took care of things. I don't like this. I like the kid. But we have no choice.
I don't want to know.
I understand. You won't. Do the boys from Boston know who it is?
Yes, they agree it's the best thing.
Nicky would have closed down this whole operation. Where would that leave us, hmm?
I'm sure he's robbing him already.
To Sam.
To Sam.
A salute.
A salute.
This is a private club. What do you want?
What? Has the cat got your tongue? Where do I know you two from?
Speak up or get the fuck out.
Us?
No, I don't.
Well, Sparrow says hello.
Wait, I know.
I know Sam would have backed me on this one. He always said you have to protect what's yours. I just didn't think it would happen this way. But when you're fenced in, you're not left with much of a choice. I was just protecting what was mine. Sorry, fellas. But there can only be one fence.